Today in this video, we are going to see an important reaction called Sonnago-Schiele coupling reaction. We are going to discuss the Sonnago-Schiele coupling reaction, the mechanism of Sonnago-Schiele coupling and examples. Let's start. Sonnago-Schiele coupling reaction. The Sonnago-Schiele coupling reaction is a cross-coupling reaction is used in the organic synthesis to form carbon-carbon bonds. It employs a palladium catalyst. This is a palladium catalyst similar to the Heck coupling. A palladium catalyst is used here. If you have not watched, I have already made a video on Heck coupling. I am giving the link in the description box. Please watch. As well as in the Sonnago-Schiele coupling, the copper co-catalyst is used to form a carbon-carbon bond between. This is a terminal alkyne. And this is a aryl or vinyl halide. This R may be of aryl or vinyl or sometimes pyridinyl may also be used in Sonnago-Schiele coupling reaction. The important point is that this reaction is stereospecific. The starting material is cis, then the product formed will be also is cis and vice versa. If the starting material is trans, then the product formed will be a trans. This is an example. This is a cis starting material. We are reacting with palladium catalyst and copper co-catalyst. This is a terminal alkyne and this is a halide which may be aryl or vinyl. The product will be of cis, like if it is trans, the product will be trans. Thus, this is stereospecific reaction. The mechanism of Sonnago-Schiele coupling. This is a palladium. These two ligands are there. First step is the oxidative addition. In this palladium and this ligands will be here. And R, which may be aryl or vinyl, will be present here. And this is a leaving group. Normally, a halogen may be a good leaving group, or OTS can be used as a leaving group, or OTF can also be used as a leaving group. And this R may be aryl or vinyl or pyridinyl. And the next step is the transmetallation. The copper cycle is not well described here. This terminal alkyne is reacting with copper halide, forming a bond between CuX here, and this is pi alkenyl complex. And after the transmetallation, this is intermediate, palladium intermediate will be formed here. In presence of X, the terminal alkyne is attached here. This is a palladium intermediate. After this, a reductive elimination happens, forming this product, and palladium is regenerated. Let us see some examples. This is a substrate. This is an aryl halide. We are reacting with alkyne, which is terminal alkyne. Here we are using palladium catalyst and copper co-catalyst. If you see palladium catalyst and copper co-catalyst, this is definitely a Sonnago-Schiele coupling. The product is the leaving group eliminates and the coupling reaction, the alkyne will couple here, forming this product. Here tertiary butyl phosphine is used in many examples for helping the reaction, which takes place at room temperature. You see the mechanism. First step, the oxidative addition. Here in the palladium, two ligands are there and the aryl group is present, and the halide, this will be added in the palladium. This is a leaving group and this is a aryl group. After that, a transmetallation which in the copper cycle reacts and forming the palladium intermediate. Here the bromine is replaced with the terminal alkyne, and after that reductive elimination happens. After the reductive elimination, the palladium will be regenerated and this will be removed and this will be coupled, and thus the product is formed here. This is another example. This is a starting material. We are reacting with terminal alkyne in presence of palladium catalyst and copper co-catalyst. The solvent used here is DMF. It is reacted with in 100 degree centigrade, forming this product. The first step, the palladium oxidative addition happens. This group will be the benzene ring will add here. OME, and the leaving group will add here, and the two ligands C3H5 is here and Cl is here. This is the oxidative addition. After that, a transmetallation happens. The iodine is replaced with this group. Here the iodine is replaced with this group, and finally the reductive elimination happens. In the reductive elimination, this product is obtained, leaving this palladium as regenerated. You see here, this is a starting material. Here the leaving group iodine is present, and this is a terminal alkyne, and this is a vinyl halide. We are reacting with palladium catalyst and copper co-catalyst in presence of pyrrolidine. The following product is obtained. The first step is the oxidative addition. Here the palladium, the ligand here will be PPH3 and PPH3. Here you see the four phenyl groups are there, four PPH3 groups are there. There will be three phenyl groups in each ligand. So because of bulkiness, it is converted into PD, PP, H3 twice. Thus, because of bulkiness, it is converted into this PDPPH3 twice. Then the oxidative addition, this alkyl chain will be added here and iodine will be here. Next is the transmetallation. The palladium intermediate is formed. Here the ligand will be here, and here the alkyl chain will be here, and here the I will be replaced by this group, and finally the reductive elimination happens. This product is obtained, leaving the palladium regenerated. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned until the next video. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe this channel.